we do. A life to live. That's why we are referred to as living sacrifices. We are to live there. We are choosing daily to offer ourselves up, our lives. But do you know what we keep doing, church? We keep doing things. We keep calling off the altar. We offer our bodies and lives to God on Sunday. By Monday, we step off the altar. Or we step off the altar as soon as we leave the front door of our church. Or we play this game where they get on the altar, then we get off the altar. Then we get on the altar, then we get off the altar. We get on the altar when we feel good. We get off the altar when life gets hard. Okay, this one. We get on the altar when we're on the worship team. And we get off the altar when we have a week off. On the altar when the spotlight is on us. We get off the altar when it's not. We get on the altar when people are watching us. We get on the altar when no one's looking. So we get off the altar when no one's looking. We get on the altar when it's convenient to us, when it makes us look good. We get off the altar when we are ashamed of what others might see us. Church, when we conform to the world, we step off the altar. The altar is where we're called to be. Our lives are made whole. Our lives are given purpose when we are resting on the altar. It is present. You are a living sacrifice. That means you need to do it while you're living. Right now. What are you waiting for? Like I said in my previous point, living sacrifice is spiritual worship and serving. We get it twisted. We think we're going to serve when we're available. I've heard that before. But when you're living a life on the altar, you let God renew your mind. Instead of saying, I'm going to serve when I'm available, I'm going to make myself available to serve. And sometimes we get scared or feel uncomfortable with the word or idea of sacrificing. We get the word of sacrifice and it has a negative connotation. I'm suffering while I'm here. But this one does not have pain. This one does not suffer to regret. People think they're going to be back to the world of this control. But actually, those that live on the altar live in true freedom. Sacrificial love is what was done for us. And it's what we must do daily. Sacrifice equals surrender. This is full surrender to God. And I intentionally requested the worship team to sing the song of the same chorus. And just like the book of Romans, the lyrics of the song paint the redemptive history. And so, God is saying, and how God sent his son to die for us for our sins in the verses. And in the chorus of the song is our response. In full surrender, with our heart abandoned, offering our heart completely to Him. And the last line of the chorus is, all I am is yours. When it's full surrender, church, that's when we choose daily to lay down our lives. We choose daily to deny our own desires. Daily live our lives in honoring and obeying Him. You know what we struggle with? Lifelong surrender or lifelong commitment. James wrote in Matthew 16, verse 24, and our two verses says, then Jesus said to his disciples, if any of you wants to be my follower, you must turn from your selfish ways, take up your cross, and follow me. Let me share something with you guys. I love it. I'm a nerd at heart. I love it when God reveals to me His wrath. My mind gets blown when I realize why a certain word was chosen over there for right. So do you guys know what I mean when I say past tense, present tense, and future tense? Right? This is what God revealed to me. we need to do it daily. Again, when the Bible uses a verb in the present tense, that means you need to do it daily. Not just once, not one and done. It's a daily thing. Give up your own way. Give up your own way daily. Turn from your selfish ways daily. Take up your cross daily. Follow me daily. This is what it means to live as a living sacrifice, living on the altar. And don't get caught up in giving excuses like, I'm not ready, I'm inadequate, I'm not good enough to be on the altar. I need to change first before offering myself. Like I said in the beginning, the altar is an encounter between God and man. The altar is where change happens. We are called to live the altar life. Turn to your neighbor and say, live the altar life. The altar life. Where God enters your life. The altar is where refining happens. What happens at an altar? Things are burned, right? Things are burned and consumed by fire. Father changes the property of things. You hear me? Fire changes the property of things. In the spiritual aspect, we offer our lives on the altar. We want to be consumed by the holy fire, and our desires, our minds are changed. Our lives are changed. Our mind is renewed. And this will only happen with full surrender. And you choosing the altar life. When we surrender our lives, we're actually surrendering it back to Him. You know, do we really mean what we sing? My life is not on my own. Love that song. But in Matthew 16:25, it says, if you try to hang on to your life, you will lose it. Holy Spirit constantly reminds us to come back if we step off the altar. That's why I really love the song, Run to the Father. But what happens? So I run to the Father again and again and again and again and again. Right? It says, my heart found a surgeon, my soul found a friend. All of that happens at the altar. The encounter of God. Our lives are changed. Our lives are complete. And we are on the other side. I'd like to call the worship team. Church, we are busy people. We have a lot of things going on in our lives. The church now is the time. We can't keep receiving instruction and never do the application. We can't just be stuck in doctrine but don't answer our call to duty. We can't just learn and learn and learn and never live it out. That's why when Paul wrote this letter, he intentionally used the word, I urge you, I plead with you to give your body to Christ. The church, now is the time. Will you conform to the world? Or will you choose to conform to the will of God? This is your choice daily. To be in daily pursuit of the will of God. Nothing less, nothing else, nothing better than that. The will of God. And by choice. I challenge you this morning to make that decision today. To give your full unreserved surrender to Him and start living life on the altar. I invite you to get on the altar. The worship team sings the song of the Spirit. Again, the